Hello and welcome to Let's Play the Elder Scrolls Arena. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Let's see how quickly I can read through this stuff. The best techniques are passed on by the survivors. Gaiden Shinji, Blade Master, First Era, 947. For centuries, different factions battled in petty wars and border conflicts until Second Era 896 Tiber Septim crushed all those who opposed him and took control, proclaiming himself as Emperor. Still, the bitter years of war had its effect on the populace. The name Tamriel, elvish for dawn's beauty, seldom fell from anguished lips and was soon forgotten. In a place where life and death were different sides of the same coin tossed every day, the people of the known world began calling the land of their sorrow the Arena. Now, 492 years after Tiber Septim took control and kept the peace, the land of Arena has a new threat. The Emperor Uriel Septim VII celebrates his 43rd birthday, but jealous hearts desire the throne and plot his downfall. It is said that hope flies on death's wings. Prepare then, for as the Elder Scrolls foretold, it will be here that your adventure begins. So welcome to this Let's Play. Just want to say a few quick things. Watch my Part Zero video. If you want more detail about the game and how I'm going to be playing it and the improvements I've put into it, or installed, rather. I want to thank Patreon members ZeniMax, Sophie Hamilton, Akatemo, Andy Semler, and Boyflee. If I've mispronounced one or two of those, I'm sorry. But I thank you guys for your support. Much appreciated. This technically is not a blind Let's Play. It is my first playthrough of the game. Well, besides me wandering around the first dungeon, I have not yet found the shift gate or left the dungeon. But, yeah, other than that, my first playthrough for this stuff, but I did do a lot of research on the game, so I can't say that it is blind anymore. So, there's that. And, that said, no spoilers, please, about any kind of plot twists. I don't know if there really are any, but, yeah. Keep it spoiler-free and all that. I do read all the things. I read the stuff on the screen as much as I can, anyway. So, except for maybe, like, repeat things and things that doesn't make sense to, you know, read aloud, something like that. So if you don't like someone who reads a lot of text on the screen, then I don't know what to tell you. This might not be for you. I do apologize for the recording icon over here in the bottom left corner. There's nothing really I can do about it. It's not supposed to be visible to in the video, just to myself. But for whatever reason, it's visible here. So there's not much I can do about it other than to, you know, not be sure if I'm recording or not, which is not good. Other than that, let's start a new game. Uriel Septim VII, not IV, Emperor of Tamriel, stands with Talon, leader of the Imperial Guards. They have been summoned by Jagar Tharn, Imperial Battlemage of the Empire, on rumors of treachery. The Emperor is betrayed and transported to a dimension of Tharn's choosing. After months of preparation, Jagar Tharn takes the throne. Rhea Somain, once Tharn's apprentice, is captured before she can warn the Elder Council of the Imperial Battlemage's treachery. Manipulating the essence of magic, Tharn prepares to take the true Emperor's place as ruler of the known land. The Imperial Wizard wastes no time in gathering his servants and turning them into twisted counterparts of the Emperor's guard. Now I'm going to get into Rhea Somain and Jagar Tharn in a moment. But as far as here, how do you wish to select your class? Now you can generate, well, choose generate, and it goes through a series of questions. What would you do if this happened? You know, where do you stand on this? Etc. Like the old Ultima games, for whoever is familiar with them. It will then choose a class for you, which you can reject and still select your own class. We're just going to select our own class. Now, it's interesting, I forgot to mention at the beginning, Gaiden Shinji is a very old warrior from the first era, I believe. He is mentioned in every main Elder Scrolls game, but as far as I know, he only appears in the Elder Scrolls Online. Interesting, but yeah, selecting. Now I am going to be a mage. Yes, I intend on finishing this game. From what I understand, starts off very weakish, but turns out becoming one of the strongest characters possible in the game if you play it right. So, what will be thy name, mage? I had one chosen, yeah. This is kind of odd. I have my keys changed around, so I have to press Alt and then Shift. Again, uppercase S. Oh, I forgot to keep pressing Alt. There we go. Skie. For those who may not know, or it may seem familiar to them, it was Kitiara's dragon in the Dragonlance series of novels. We will be female. From where dost thou hail, Skie the Mage? Skie the Mage hails from High Rock. Thou hast chosen High Rock, land of the Bretons. Wouldst thou accept this as thy home? Yes, I wouldst. That was interesting. From after Daggerfall, they dropped the whole wouldst, thy, and thou, and everything. And a lot of people are happy about that. Then thou wilt be known as the Mage Skie, who wouldst call High Rock, land of the Bretons, her home. Know ye this also, thy race is descended from the ancient druids of Galen, quick-witted and strong in the mystical arts. I wonder if that's still canon. Bretons descended from ancient druids of Galen. Thy folk are crafty and intelligent, a learned people who use their gifts to guide others to enlightenment. Thy body and mind must be intelligent and willful if thou art to succeed as a mage. I am aware. Go ye now in peace. Let thy fate be written in the Elder Scrolls. Distribute thy points as needed, keeping in mind the recommendations for thy chosen class. Okay, well, these are good. Speed, not so good. Strength, not so good. Oh my god, endurance, 39. 11 bonus points. I might reroll that. 19 bonus points. But look how low we start out. What can I do with this? Now keep in mind, all these attributes, 50 is like the average kind of, you know, citizen of Tamriel. Anything under 50 is less than average. Over is, you know, you're getting better than the average person. I believe it caps out at 100, so if you get everything to 100, you're basically, I guess, a god amongst mortals or something. So what if I get these to 65? Basically, yeah, will is your magic defense. So if I get to 65, the magic defense is plus 3. That's pretty good. And intelligence, of course, affects your spell points. This is all very Dungeons and Dragons inspired. So it looks like every point of intelligence gets us 2 spell points. I wonder if it keeps giving two. 1, 2, 6, 8, 9, 10. It does, at least that much. But I don't want to waste it all on this. We need strength to be able to carry some of this stuff. So I think to start out at 65 is pretty decent. We do damage minus 1 because our strength is so low. We get to 43, we no longer suffer a penalty on damage. Agility is pretty good. 2 hit plus 1. If I get it up to 60, we get plus 2. Unfortunately, we can't lower it below what they've already given us. Speed is 55. Endurance, 41. Not too good. Can't even get it. I just want to see something. Endurance. We have to get it to... Wow, even at 51 is nothing. Health plus 1 if you get to 55. Wow. And this is personality. Basically, you got the basic D&D stats. So they've renamed a few of them. Strength, intelligence, wisdom, agility, speed, which is, I guess, dexterity. Endurance, which is stamina. Personality, which is charisma, and an extra luck stat. So, magic defense plus 2, plus 3, I like that. Yeah, well, I didn't want... I didn't increase any of these, I'm pretty sure, yeah. We're going to stick with this. Strength 43. I'm going to be increasing that soon. To carry things. Intelligence 65. And willpower or will the same. Agility 57. Speed 55. Endurance 46. Personality and luck 48. So you have plus 0 to damage. 130 spell points. Plus 3 magic defense. Plus 1 to hit. Plus 1 to defend. Health and heal modifier plus 0, charisma plus 0. Now as we level up, we're going to get points. Points will be in here. They won't be called bonus points. They'll just be points, I think. And then we can up these even more. There's no skills in this game. You just increase these stats, and it also increases these little things. So our health is 26, fatigue 89. We have start up with 135 gold. Level 1. Saving the stats. Thou wilt now choose thy appearance. Thy mien can be altered by clicking thy face. Mien basically means face, or mien, or appearance. When thou art finished, select done to enter the world of Tamriel, home of the arena. They keep throwing this arena stuff at you because they had to explain why it's called the Elder Scrolls Arena. In-game explanation as well. Everything is so war-torn, and there's monsters and bandits all over that it's like an arena. It's like a dangerous combat all over kind of thing. Like, that's day-to-day life, that's the world as we know it, blah blah blah. Out of universe explanation? Well, they were going to make an arena combat game and changed their mind and decided to make an RPG, but all the box art and promotional material was already created, and they're like, we can't afford to do this over again, or we don't want to spend the money, so we'll put the Elder Scrolls on top and call it the Elder Scrolls Arena, and then explain it away with this in-world explanation. Oh. I was looking for my cursor, and I had to click away the window.
Do not fear, for it is I, Rhea Silmane. Listen to me. There are no others left to carry on this fight. You have been left in this cell to die. Jagar Tharn, Imperial Battle, Mage of Tamriel, has taken on the guise of the true Emperor.
Tamriel?
He does not see you as a threat, being only a minor part of the Imperial Court. In that act of arrogance, he has made his first mistake. Look to the north wall of the cell. You will find a ruby key which will unlock the door. Take it and make your escape. The passages here were once used by Tharn to hide treasures he had stolen from the Emperor's coffer. If you wish, you can gather enough to support yourself away from the Imperial seat. Be careful. There are many creatures which inhabit the sewers now. Vile rats and goblins. It is too late for me, for I am already dead. Only my powers as a sorceress keep me between this life and the next. That power, however, is waning. Do not succumb to greed, or you may find these tunnels to be your final resting place as well. I can still work my magic to a certain extent. If you travel west from this cell, then south, you will find a shift gate. It will transport you far enough from the center of the Empire that you should be safe. If you survive these sewers, you will see me again. Remember, Tharn has taken on the guise of the Emperor. No one will gainsay his word for yours. I will come to you again in your dreams, so it is imperative that you rest from time to time. In that way, I will be able to communicate with you and lend my aid. You are entering a dangerous arena, my friend, one in which the players are beings beyond your mortal comprehension. I do not envy your role. There is, however, a power within you, as yet untapped. Look for me when you have gained experience in the world. You are my last and best hope.
Basically, as you gain a level, rest, and then she'll talk to you again. So, you awaken to the drip of water from somewhere above. The cell walls are covered in slime and stuff. I think we're running too quickly here. Not sure. Okay, so here's our map. That's us. That's fight. You can also press F in my case, with my key set up at least. That is pickpocketing, I think, which you're not going to be using because we're a mage type. You are in the Imperial Dungeons. It's 12:10 in the afternoon. Blah, 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 blah. You are currently carrying 0 of 86 kilograms. You are healthy. So if you were poisoned or diseased, it would say that other than besides you are healthy. We have Fire Dart and Light Heal as spells. Our logbook is empty. We could print it if we had a printer installed. That's camp. Didn't mean to do that. Trying to get to... Oh, I think we clicked that. Okay. So here's our character, and then the next page. A dagger. We can equip the dagger. Doesn't help anything. Now, what's interesting is that these numbers will go down as we put on armor, which isn't going to be much as far as armor because we're a mage, but they will go down a little bit. And basically what this is bonus damage. So when enemy hits you, it does 9 more damage than it normally would. And this will go down until you get to minus, to get to negative numbers, And it's basically, for those familiar with Dungeons and Dragons, it's like Thaco. You know, the armor class goes down, the better it gets, etc. Alright, so it seems like we're running quick here, so let me just see something. Maybe. You have found a ruby key. Now, what some people seem to space on is, like, why would they leave the key to your cell in the cell? It was Rhea Silmaine who put the key there. The manual explains that. The other thing about Jagar Tharn is that, he's impersonated the Emperor. And you would wonder, why not just kill the Emperor and bury his body somewhere, or have it blown to pieces or something like that? Well, it has to do with the Amulet of Kings, which this power was not seen again in mentions of the Amulet of Kings, such as in Oblivion, I believe. Basically, the Amulet of Kings, if the king were to die, the Amulet of Kings would warn the Elder Council, or would inform the Elder Council that the Emperor is now dead. So, by sending him to another dimension, well, the Emperor is still alive. And what he does is he sends him to a dimension where time moves more slowly. You can retcon this as it's a plane of Oblivion, which it is. I just don't know which plane they would decide that to be. So basically the Emperor would live for hundreds of years more before he passed away, and by then, you know, Jagar Tharn could drop his disguise and, you know, it would be too late for everybody. Now, I went over this in my Part Zero video. The reason the music sounds better than normal is because I'm using a virtual MIDI synth, which is one of several programs you can run sound fonts on. I'm running the Arachno sound font, which is basically taking the MIDI instructions and using them with much better quality instruments and such. The Munt emulator sounds like crap. The quality here is normal 3x for the scaler. I believe I'm running Cycles Fix 20,000, but I might be increasing that when I'm hitting my record key. I'm not sure. Mem size I'm making 64, and I don't know what difference that makes. And normally, when you go like that, you hear a little click somewhere in the middle of this swing as part of, you know, the sound effect. There's a sound patch on the Nexus mods, which removes the click. So I'll put links to this in the description, and I've remapped a lot of things, not exactly the way I'd want, but a little better. For example, I don't have to press Shift J to jump, I can just press space. So, and then my strafe is tied to some other keys, so I might not be strafing as much. And other than that, like I stated before, we don't really have the lore in this. The corridors here seem twisted and confusing, but Rhea's instructions were to go west and then south to find the shift gate. Now, what's interesting here is you can do this. Bag of 20 gold pieces, claymore, and a long sword. Did I already turn that on? There's a way to turn off the pixelization, which I thought it would happen at that treasure pile, but you don't see it there. So There's also a long sword, we cannot use that. And a claymore, which you cannot use either. I think... I'm not completely sure. The long sword might be magical. Interesting. So we're stuck with our dagger here. Just getting used to the controls a little bit. It's gonna take a little while. Oh! So you swing by swinging your mouse around, basically, and holding on to the right mouse button. Right, the goblin has nothing usable. See that? Also stupid how it says you see a goblin like that. So if you press F4, you're welcome. You don't have to wait for things to pixelize in. Some questionable decisions. But it was 94 after all. So we got water here. We got a... I'm gonna hang around in here for a little while. Sometimes you don't hear sounds. The music prevents you from hearing the sound, and sometimes the sound prevents you from hearing music. Which it can be alarming sometimes, because you'll have something come up and hit you from behind, and you won't hear yourself being hit. I guess this speed is okay. Wait, I heard that. Something's coming after me. Dead end. Well, that might have been that door closing. The one I exited out of. Now these niches... It seems safe to rest in these niches. You think the rats or other creatures may not smell you. Something about drafts being too low. There's a draft close to the floor or something which carries your smell? Yeah, with the draft that runs so close to the floor. I heard that. Someone stuck in the door? Whack you, yes I will. So, there's nothing there. I forgot to check this one. Nothing usable. You see a goblin, I know. I killed it already. Maybe he came out of here. Ooh, we got some treasure. Ooh, a bag of 20 gold pieces and a plate pauldron. Can't equip that either. Okay. A staff and an iron helm. I didn't change my... I guess that's okay. I don't know. Did I forget to change my face? It's unfortunate. And I guess I'll keep it the same. So, the dagger, if you right click, damage 1 to 6. Here the staff is damage 1 to 8. Slightly used, though. I'll still use it. You can reach things a lot from further away. Now that thing might break, but at least we'll have the dagger. Yes, the niches. Oh, my God. Oh. Back, you curs. I hit that by mistake. Oh! Where are you? Oh my God. Get in the niche! Rest. I cannot camp. Enemies are nearby. Go. That was loud. Okay. Oh, it still does say bonus points. Alright. Seems stupid for a mage, but I know we want our endurance up. And our strength up. I want to get everything up to 50 at least, and then start increasing the spell points and such. Now... Wait. Yeah, which one was I in? Light heal. Alright, that works. I would preferably like to rest, though. Until fully healed.
I see you have strengthened your arm and your mind. It is time we began this journey. This is the Staff of Chaos, the one item that can open the door between this world and the dimension to which the Emperor has been banished. Tharn used this item to destroy my corporeal form. When I tried to warn the Council, he knew that the Staff of Chaos was nigh indestructible, having been made from the essence of the land itself. But in that he found the key. As the land is split, so did he shatter the staff into 8 perfectly formed pieces. These he scattered across the realm. I have been able to divine the location of the first piece, a place called Fang Lair. It is said that Fang Lair was originally built by the dwarves of Kragan. Legend has it that a great worm drove the dwarves from their home in the dragon's teeth and took the lair for itself. I only wish I knew the exact location. Perhaps there are sages or scholars who would know of this place. Somewhere in its dank depths lies the first piece of the Staff of Chaos. I wish you well. I do not think Tharn knows of your escape. But I can do little else in this form. I have tried to obscure your identity with a spell, but I do not know how well it will hide you. Take care, for Tharn may be searching. Go forth with the blessings of the true Emperor, and myself.
I shall. And you know what? I forgot to increase the detail up. I don't know how much that makes a difference. And I'm going to be changing the sound and music around a little bit. Because right now I have it as running in the lower volume in the Windows mixer. So that's basically what it is. It's basically, well, okay, she knows that the next staff piece is in Fang Lair, but she does not know where Fang Lair is. So you speak to the ruler of whatever place you end up, that you, oh, you have to go to this province, and you speak to the ruler of that province, and you have to do a favor for her or find something out in another dungeon, and she'll tell you, well, okay, according to this map, or this Elder Scroll, or whatever, the Fang Lair is over here. So then you go to Fang Lair, and then you find the actual staff piece. Rinse and repeat for the next 7 staff pieces. So, that's what this basically is, dungeon crawling, and basically you're, you know, improving, buying items, improving items, you rest at inns and such, and we'll get to all that soon. Pretty much, I have not played past this, but as you know, I've been doing my research, so I know quite a bit about how this is all going to go, and it's rather simple, but it's bound to be lots of fun, nonetheless. So I want to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Always, seek adventure.